At this point, num1 is having some unmodified value, but num2 is having garbage value. At this point, num2 and num1 both are having some unmodified value. So whenever I am calling this add, it means add, and inside this some value entered by user, and here also it will be some value entered by user, right? So if user have entered say 2 and 4, then it will be something like this at this stage. Now whenever it will see this, it will not go further inside the second line of main. If I am writing sub num1 and num2, that is finding the subtraction, it will not go there. It will, when it will find this add, it does not know what exactly the add is. So it will go on the above list. If there exists any function named as add, yes it is, it is. So what it does, whatever value is inside this, it will copy this value to this A. So at this stage, A and B was having some garbage value, but when this function calling of function happen inside main, this 2 is copied to A. So now my A is having 2 and now B is having 4. So what exactly, see, you cannot do semicolon over there. So what exactly is being done? Now A is 2 and B is 4. I want A plus B, that's why inside this I am taking int same sum equal to, or you can write as sum equal to A plus B, and here you can write return sum. So what is happening over here? Right now A is 2, B is 4. A is 2, B is 4. Sum is created, sum is at this point is having garbage value, but at this point sum become 4 plus 2, that is 6. So 6 is there. Now return sum. So return this value 6. Where it should be returned, where it is called. So here 6 is returned where the function is called. Where it is called? Inside main. So now this 6 is returned here. So here exactly the answer is 6. So you can write that here it will be 6. But you cannot have single value. So that's why here you are having int, some kind of variable res, right? Here you are having variable res, and res equal to, you can write, you can also define res with num1, num2 also. So it is not an issue. You can also define res as here also. So here res equal to this. So as the value of this entire function is 6 now, because it returns sum, that is 6. So now res become 6. So here you can printf, the addition is %d, and that is res, right? Now sum, after that sub is there. So you have to write int sub, because for subtracting two integer numbers you will get you will have two input as int numbers. You can you can use A and B also, you can use C and D also, that doesn't matter. So here you can also write int sub, int C, int D, or any other variable. I am taking it as int A and C. You can take as different name. I am taking this kind of name so that you can differentiate them, right? Now here I can also take, say, sum subtraction. Make sure that you don't use name similar to, you cannot write sub over here because sub is a function name. So here subtraction equal to whatever value inside A minus C, and at the end it will return subtraction. Now here what is happening? Suppose user had entered 2 and 4 is num1 and num2. So what is being called over here? Sub 2 and 4. right? So sub 2 and 4 is called. So it will not go for the second line. It will go to the function definition, that is here. So here it will copy 2 variable a, and new variable c is created inside which 4 is created. Now one may say that ma'am, we have already created int a in sum. So this both are similar or different? This both are similar, but a is now having replaced value with this 2. So a is having 2 and c is having 4. This values are copied there. Now another variable is created, name is subtraction. Inside subtraction I am saving a minus b, that is 2 minus 4. So now subtraction is minus 2. So entire function will have a value minus 2. So this entire is having minus 2. I cannot have single value. So now I am writing res equal to minus 2. Now what was the previous value of res? Here value of res was 6. Now that 6 is overwritten with minus 2. You can also use res 1, res 2, res 3, res 4 for 4 different results. Right? You can also use res 1, 2, res 3 and res 4. You can also use this. But why to create extra variables when I can simply write it without creating them? So that's why I am simply writing here res equal to sub. Right, and similar way I am printing this over here. So here also it will be, so here subtraction is percentage b and res. Right, now you can do similar thing for multiplication. So I am not explaining it right now. So you can guess this output. Now what about the division? So for division, what you need? For division, I am calling div number and num2. Right? Now you know that whenever I am dividing one two integers, the output will be integer. So now what I can do? I can use typecasting, but I cannot use typecasting over here. For division, I have to use typecasting over the definition. So here, the output I am expecting is float. That's why I am writing return type as float. Here it will be div, and inside this I am writing int a and int b. Right? You can write any variable name over there. These are called formal parameters. These all are called formal parameters, and whatever we have used in this, num1 and num2 are called actual parameter. Right? So now I am taking one float variable c. C is equal to, now I have to use typecasting so that I get correct answer. So float a, so it will convert a to float. Now if I am dividing one float with integer, the according to the implicit type conversion, it will be automatically float answer. So I am returning float right now. I am returning c. So here, whenever I am writing this statement over here, it will be the division is, here it should be percentage f, right? Here it should be percentage f, but this res is int. Do you get that point or not? So either you can write float, or you can do something like this. So now res is having some float value, or we have to take another variable which is float, so it will be very convenient. So res 1, as it is having different data type, I am using res 1 over here. Here also res 1. Now let me just save this program. compile it. What is the problem? Scan F. Num2 was not declared. Okay. Now again, let me just compile it and run it. I am entering say 2 and 4. Addition is 6. Subtraction is -2. Multiplication is 8. And division is not printed. Why it is not printed? Let me just check. RES is float. Here I have not written anything. So it is percentage F. Let me compile it and run it again. 2 and 4. You can see the correct output over there. So this is how you can write a function of calculator. Now one may ask that, ma'am, this is having similar length with the code, right? So I have taken this example to make you understand function clearly. But whenever you are writing so many long programs, and suppose you want to add, you have to add this code, entire code, again after some time, right? Or after some time you have to add numbers. So again after 100 lines of code you are going to write this code. So it is having some kind of frequency. To eliminate that kind of code, we are using function. For the small program, you cannot understand the efficiency. But for the larger modules, when you are going to do a job or something, at that time, you will understand the importance of functions. So using the functions is really very efficient. Using the function makes your program very efficient. If you have any doubt, let me do one correction, one addition over here. Suppose what about if you don't want to return anything? So whenever you are not returning anything, you are just using print, at that time you can use void. So I am making one function void p, which is not having any argument, right? So you can see I have not written any input over here. Here instead void I am writing printf, or I am okay. So here printf hello Kim Cho, right? So if I am just doing P over here, I am not expecting any output. I just want P to print something on screen. So if I just compile it and run it, you can see hello Kim Cho is printed, because the program execution starts with main. Inside main it will encounter P. It knows that what is it is P is, because it is already defined over. It will go inside this, it will print this and come to here. And program terminated. So this is all about functions. Now I am going to see the four types of user defined function, that is with argument and without argument, and with return type and without return type. I hope you understand this class and concepts. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section. Thank you so much. See you in the next class.